Thank you. And please excuse my English. I hope it's enough. Okay, let me start. Hi everybody. This is teacher Eugenia Calderon, and I am going to present, to show my lecture titled Second Life as a Tool for Spanish Teaching. Okay, we have presented this title in Spanish last week. And now we are going to repeat the presentation in English. For our English speakers, the last presentation for our Spanish speakers, for now, our English presentation, okay? So let me start, yeah. My presentation is Second Life as a Tool for Spanish Teaching. Let me load the next slide. We are going to work on this, here it is, of this, how can I say, this list of topics. We are going to talk about Instituto Español Second Life. It's our first topic. We are going to answer the question, why Second Life? We are going to answer the question, is it possible to recreate a class in Second Life? We are going to talk about tools in Second Life, like the title say. Other tools, we are going to talk about that. Other topic is organization of artistic and cultural activities. Then we continue with Radio Spanish Speak and theater workshop, collaborative action, and a summary of the topic, okay? Let me start with Instituto Español Second Life. Why? To explain why I am here in Second Life, why I am using Second Life to teach, okay? Okay, it is taking some second to see the, okay, it is. Here it is. Well, why I am in Second Life? Well, I started 6 years ago. I was invited to participate in Second Life. I didn't know Second Life. I didn't know anything about Second Life. And somebody, one man arrives to our city. Well, he lives in our city. Ross Bronson, Wilson Boyd in Second Life. He invited us, me and a group of teachers, to participate in this adventure, to teach Spanish in Second Life. It was, for me, it was a very, very surprise. I discovered that this world is very funny, very awesome place to teach. And well, we invited by Ross Bronson to participate to teach Spanish in Second Life, because he created a school, a virtual school, Instituto Español Second Life. Now the name is Second Life Spanish. Okay, we have, so Ross has made some changes at the school, so we are Second Life Spanish. But at the beginning, in Instituto Español, we invited by Ross Bronson, and the idea of this wonderful man was to offer the student the possibility to study Spanish before to visit a Spanish country, and they can study it's their Spanish from their homes. Okay, at the home they can study in their pijamas. So they couldn't, or they didn't spend too much money. Okay, because the classes are cheap. Yeah, they are cheap. And other reason he invited us, because he offered us an opportunity to get a job. We work only on holidays, on vacations, summer vacation. So the other days of the year, we don't have a job. we don't have the possibility to get money. Okay, so he offered us the opportunity to work all the days, all the year in a virtual school. So, and I accepted. It was hard for me to learn how to use Second Life, but I am here now. So I enjoy a lot to teach in Second Life. Now let's go to the slide number 4. Please let me loading. I have to load each slide. And okay, we have to wait. Here it is. Why Second Life? Okay, why we use Second Life? I'm happy to use Second Life. Why? Because we can recreate an educational environment. Oh my God, my English. Educational environment. Yes, we at the real life schools, we organize events, we offer our class, we have classrooms, we have boards, we have activities, cultural activities, movies, as we can see in the presentation. Can you see? This is my blackboard and my classroom. Here we are offering a play. Yeah, we can make plays, recreate plays. Here we are seeing a movie. Here we are in a special activity. And here I am offering a lecture. We are going to talk about a little more about any of all of these activities. Okay, we are going to talk more about these activities. We can recreate it. Sometimes we have some problems. Yeah, it's not perfect, but we can recreate a class, an environment, educational environment here in Second Life. Okay, so that is the reason we can use Second Life. Mm-hmm. We can make field trips, role play games, cultural and artistic activities. So it is Second Life is an excellent tool to teach languages. Mm-hmm. And I am using Second Life to teach Spanish. Okay, so let me continue with the next slide, number 5. Let's go to the number 5 slide. And we are going to answer the question if it is possible to recreate a class in Second Life. Yes, it is possible. In one of our other presentation, other teacher talk about the it is not good idea to give a class, a formal class in Second Life. It's better to work with another activities. Yes, I am agree with that teacher. But we have students have different ways to learn. Okay. Taking the grammar, having a special activity, and we in Second Life, we can do that. Mm-hmm. We can offer a class, mm-hmm, in my classroom, for example. That is my classroom in Second Life. You can visit us if you want. We can use boards, like we see. Here I am in a special class, on radio class. And we can use other tools, okay? For example, here we are doing a play with two of my students, my advanced students. We can make parties. Yeah, parties helps to practice to learn a language here in Plaza Luna. In this place is Spanish speak inside Second Life. I work here in this place in Spanish speak. I continue working with Wilson, with Ross Bronson. And we are doing a conversational practice in a restaurant, talking about food, about things in a kitchen. So we have too much possibilities, opportunities to practice the language, to use Second Life and learn the language, okay? In this picture, I'm sorry if I have too much picture of my in my slides because we have a lot of activities, so we have a lot of pictures. Okay, so here we organized a carnival of Mazatlán, and part of our activities is to organize the artistic and cultural activities, and carnival is important in Mazatlán in this case. So here we recreate the carnival of Mazatlán. So yes, we could answer that question. Is it possible to recreate a class in Second Life? Yes, not exactly a formal class. Okay, all the opportunity, all the activities to teach a language. Mm-hmm. Now let's continue with the slide number 6. Wait for me. Number 6. Okay, take some second. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, we have to wait. Okay, yeah, it is. So we say the title is Second Life as a Tool for Spanish Teaching. Let's talk about the tools. Mm-hmm. The tools are, we are going to talk about one by one, avatars, virtual books, screen and whiteboards, animation, gesture, note cards, words, and construction. All Second Life is a tool. Mm-hmm. And in Second Life, and not only in Second Life, we can use other virtual worlds, but here we are going to see the tools in Second Life. Okay, avatars, very important, very, very important to teach. They are our image, our copy, our person inside the world. Okay, so very important to teach. We are going to talk a little more about avatars. Okay, now let me explain first the virtual books. When I started my classes, I asked myself, how can I send or give the material, the information of my student, to my student? Well, the books. We can use emails or different social networks, but here in Second Life, we had the possibility to use books, virtual books. Here, let me show you. This is one of my books. Mm-hmm. This annual book, we have changed. They have some changes, but here we have the books we use. Those are the books I use. This is inside the information inside the book. They have the grammar, exercises. To make a book is a lot of work. Yeah. So they have all the information. See, the grammar, the exercises, the lectures, the cultural information. I am very proud of my books. So if you someday want to study Spanish with me, you are going to have this information on the books. Of course, we can use also email to get the information of the class. Okie dokie. Okay, note cards. The note cards. Yeah, we use note cards also. Note cards are a very good way to make some exercises. Here we have a song. Uh-huh. We were singing a song, and the student can make the note, the homeworks. We ask homeworks all the time. On the note card, I correct the note card, I send the note card to my student, they can send me the information, the works, the homeworks several days before the classes. And we send each other note cards to check the information, to have the exercises, okay? So note cards is a good tool in our Spanish classes. So we have books and note cards. We have avatars. Here we were celebrating the Mexican Revolution. That is very good. Second Life is. I like Second Life. Our avatars led us to wear some outfits, and it is cheap, not so expensive. If we do that in real life, our avatars can transform themselves to a special activity. Okay, Mexican Revolution is here, so avatars are good. But let me talk a little more about the avatars. Okay, please let me change to the 7th slide. Mm-hmm. In 7th slide, slide 7, we are going to talk about avatars. Here it is. The avatars not only led us to transform ourselves into a specific character. No. We can perform different roles in our activities, in our role games, role play games, I mean. Avatars are very important. They are a major role. They play a major role in the process of teaching, of course. Why? Because one reason is they provide us a sense of presence. Uh-huh. They let us to create the contact between a teacher and a student. Okay, I have my avatar. My avatar in Second Life is Eugenia Calderón. And she is the teacher. She is she looks like a teacher, like a teacher, like a language teacher. Okay, we, the language teacher, we are not so formal. We can use, if you are here in Second Life, let me see Second Life. In Second Life, you can see my avatar, very informal, very fresh, using sneakers, is that correct that way? Tennis shoes, and like I do in real life, huh? Very comfortable. Why? Because we, in our Spanish class, we are comfortable, okay? We have confidence, so we only change our avatar, me, the teacher, and the student. We can go to the class in short, okay? Because in real life, we teach the language like that, in an informal scenario. So our avatars represent us, uh-huh, in Second Life. See, they are our representation, our bodies in Second Life, okay? Let me continue with the slide number 8. We are going to continue talking about avatars. Avatars let us, okay, meanwhile, yeah, here it is. Our avatars let us to play a role, okay? Give us the confidence to play roles. Somebody say Second Life is a game and education is not good in Second Life. Of course not. We can play. Uh-huh. We can play and learn at the same time, okay? Or learning, playing, okay? How can I say that? Okay, we play. If we play, it is funny. Yeah, it is funny to learn a language, to learn Spanish, playing, okay? So we can play a specific role, not necessary. We can, our avatars let us or help us to avoid the fear. We are not worried to be judged or criticized because our avatars are playing that role. Okay, and it is funny. It is very, very funny. Me, for example, in our specific activities, in our plays, we play a role of, how can I say, a witch, for example. And don't say bad words, of course, okay? A witch in a play, of course. We can be husband and wife, and for example, here we are in a play. Mm-hmm. My student are a husband and a wife. We are having a party here. We can play some roles here, for example, over here also. And here we were celebrating Halloween. Celebrating Halloween to a Spanish class, in a Spanish class? What? Well, no, there is a reason, Okay. We were comparing. Part of our practice, our classes are to compare different cultural, our cultural differences. Okay. Here we were celebrating Halloween in the context of the Day of the Dead. Okay, we were comparing Halloween. Yeah, we say Halloween in Spanish like that, exactly. We were partying. We had a party in the context of Day of the Dead to compare. Okay, to compare Day of the Dead and Halloween. To discover our cultural differences, that helps to understand, okay, to understand the language, the cultural differences. Why not? Now let's continue with the slide number 9. In the slide number 9, we have more images about the avatars, the way we use avatars here, for example. Other good tools. The avatars are a very good tools to teach a class, because they help to reduce student anxiety. Of course, they helps a lot. Uh-huh. If we are nervous to be in front of our teacher, it's okay, no problem. Why? Because our avatars give us, how can I say, like, I don't know how to say, a way not to feel the fear. Coraza in español. Okay. They help us. Okay. Avatars helps to decrease the nervousness, to reduce the anxiety. Mm-hmm. Agile. Thank you. Thank you very much. Uh-huh. Avatars give us a shield. I'm sorry of my pronunciation. A shield, exactly. Uh-huh. They give us a shield to protect us, to reduce the nervousness, to reduce the anxiety. Yeah, they help a lot. And we can work with more confidence. Okay, we can work more with more relaxing. If we have a mistake, for example, like I write here in the slide, yo soy hablando español. That is not correct in Spanish, okay? But if they say that, it's okay, no problem. Why? Because the avatar, he has the mistake. He made the mistake. So help us, okay? Help us in the process to learn a language, okay? So avatars are a good tool to teach a language. Okay, what else? Let me go to the slide number 10. Let's continue with another tool. Uh-huh. We are going to talk about tools in Second Life. Other tools are screens and whiteboards. Yes, Avatar Second Life offers us a lot of tools. Screen and whiteboards, for example. There are a lot of kind of screens in Second Life. To different uses. I am using a special screen in Second Life. If you are here in Second Life with me, that is a screen, a free screen. We can buy other screen, of course. We have to buy something, but they are not so expensive. We can invest. We Spanish teacher. If we want to work here in Second Life, yeah, we have to spend some money, but not too much like in real life. Okay, the investment is lower than in real life. Well, in another things we have to spend a little more. But in Second Life, the tools in Second Life are not expensive. So here I am using the Blackboard of our school. Mm-hmm. For me, it's for free. Thank you, Ross Bronson. Well, we can see movies, if you can see special blackboards here. Here is a class, it's not my class, it's a class of other land here in Second Life. Here we were seeing a movie, some videos of the Guelaguetza. So we have the possibility to use a different screens, a different whiteboards to present our class. Okay, not only the student have the information in our books by email, of course, but also by images here inside Second Life. So we can use screens and whiteboards. A lot of there are a lot of okay. As I are a builder, special builders of Blackboard, and I thank them to give us this opportunity to use these screens to offer our classes. Now let's continue with our slide number 11. The 11th slide. In the 11th slide, we are going to talk about gesture and animation. Yep, Second Life offers that that tools also. Lecture and animation. Why? Okay, sorry, gesture and animation. Here, this is me. Beautiful, right? we can, our avatars can, we have hoods, it's hard to pronounce that word, some things to change the animation of our avatars. Here we were dancing, we were practicing some verbs, dance, to dance, to talk, to have a party. The animation of our avatars led us to practice the language. Here, for example, I am smiling, so we can smile. We smile, okay? Here, feelings, talking about feelings. I am angry. Here, I am surprised or maybe sad. Yeah, there are only a few examples. Our avatars have a lot of animation, a lot of gestures. Second Life, for example, the furnitures have a lot of animation, and we can use that animation. Doesn't matter if the animation are or the instruction are in English. That doesn't matter. I use my English, not in the class. I mean, I can translate that animation into Spanish, and then I use the animation of furniture, not only in special furniture in our place, in our classroom. No, we can visit, we can make field trips, and even use the animation of the stores. Mm-hmm. I hope the owner of the store don't push me to go out. Yeah, okay. Yeah, we could use all that animation. I am going to sleep. I am sleeping. I slept. Okay, all the tenses we can use practicing using the animation of the furniture in Second Life. Here, I am taking a bath, not naked, because we can use porn images. Because that is the reason she is not naked. Okay, but here we talk about the activities on the bathroom, the reflexive verbs in Spanish. I am taking a bath. It's different tenses, different topics using the animation of the furnitures in Second Life. So we can't. Second Life is a tool to teach a class. Now let's continue with the slide number 12. And talk about the wait for a second. Wait. Here it is. Okay. Building, construction. Okay. Yep. Is another tool to teach Spanish, to teach a language. For example, here is, let me show, here is the Instituto Español Second Life. We are changing in our land. That is the last scenario we had, but okay, we are in a transition period, so we don't have that now, but later. Okay, here, this is Instituto Español Second Life. Here we can do a lot of things. We did some activities. At this place, some something very good which is good in Second Life is we can recreate, we can build places, places of the real life, okay? Here we have a special museum, a special building in Mexico, ¿sí? The Alhóndiga de Granaditas is a museum. And we recreate, we have builders in Second Life. Of course, I am not build that, no, I am not the builder, no, but in Spanish speak, we have builders who recreate, who copy this building for us. So we can offer the real life, the real life, we can offer the real life inside Second Life. We can talk about this place. We have special activities. I offer lectures about a special historic event in Mexico. I am from Mexico, by the way. So we have, we can do that in Second Life. Okay, here we have another museum of Mexico, Mexico, the Guadalupe Posada Museum. And we, it's the same. We at Spanish Speak, Second Life Spanish, we organize different events along the year. In the year, we have special activities, Mexican Revolution, Independence of Mexico, Day of the Dead, a lot of activities in along of the year. So we recreate according with the time that the celebration we are doing. We create the buildings. Here in this building, this is the building for La Guelaguetza. It's a party. La Guelaguetza is a party from the state of Oaxaca in Mexico. So we have this scenario exist in real life. So we can copy that scenario. It is a very, very good work of our builders. Me, I can't do all the thing I do without that person, the very important person, our builders, our cultural manager, the owner of the place. It would be impossible for me to do all of that with the work of the Spanish Second Life Spanish team. Okay, and here this place and this place is Mi Casa Es Su Casa. Mi casa es su casa, my house is your house, is the translation. Mi casa es su casa is a special place to practice Spanish. The owner is the teacher Calixto Encinal in Second Life. He let us, the Spanish teacher, to use this place. So, well, if he is listening, I hope so. I have to say thank you. Thank you to Calixto, thank you to the owner of Spanish Speak also, to use these scenarios to teach Spanish. Okay, number 13. The 13th slide. Let me drink some waters. Okay, other tools. Well, not only, we could use Second Life, of course, but we can combine Second Life with other tools, okay? I mean, in some of my classes, we can, with our tool, if we want to sing a song, for example, in Spanish, to read some lyrics in Spanish, we use YouTube, for example. Here is, in YouTube, this is wonderful tool to, how can I say, to join, okay, tools in Second Life, tools out in Second Life. We can, sing the songs, for example, we connect at the same time the YouTube videos. And sometimes our students are a little shy, they don't sing, and I sing, not very good, but I try. And we use YouTube, for example, okay? This is a video in the place of Smithsonian theme. The Smithsonian SIM, so bad the SIM is not working now, but they have excellent videos of Mexican culture, Latin music, and I let me use that place to my classes. So I hope someday Smithsonian open again their SIM, it seems. And Facebook, yeah, well, for our business, yeah, because teach Spanish could be a business, well, it's a business, we could use social networks, okay, like Facebook, like Twitter, like other, well, a lot of, I have more experience about social networks, but we could use, okay? And Google, very important for us, for me, for my classes, and I suggest teachers, if they use this kind of tools, Google Calendar, for example, and I have another, well, we could use a lot of social networks. In Google Calendar, for example, here, you can check our classes, our activities, and if we are not in world, if we are not free to attend, you can check our calendar in Google Calendar, like the images here. So we can join, okay, we can join our tools in Second Life and website networks. Okay, wikis, I asked my students to search, to investigate different topics, to study a different a special topic using wikis or the cultural pages, a lot of information of countries, Mexico. So we have the possibility to how can I say, to fly on internet and look for Spanish, is information in Spanish. So that is a good way also to learn a language. So we don't need to be in front of us direct, okay? Or they don't need to come back Mexico. Yeah, the idea is, yeah, someday they come back, visit Mexico, especially in my city, and continue their studies, but they can start. They can start using Second Life and internet, okay? So it is a, well, internet is a good tool to teach a language. It's an special Second Life. Okay, let's go to the slide number 14. Please wait for me. And we are going to talk about cultural activities. Part of our activities to support the classes is with the organization of artistic and cultural activities. Like I said, we here in Spanish Speak, we do a lot of activities all the year. Okay, next month, for example, we are going to celebrate the May 5th, el Cinco de Mayo. And we are going to talk about that, have an exhibition, a lecture, some special activities. We will have the program in our school. Okay, what kind of artistic and cultural activities? For example, the International Women's Day, celebration of Independence of Mexico, the Mexican Revolution, Day of the Dead, Christmas, concerts, karaoke or karaoke, cultural lectures. All of that activities are organized here. Well, not only by me, okay? All the team in our school in Second Life Spanish. We are activists about women's rights. So we are participating or doing something about women's rights. In this case, International Women's Day. Here, let me show you the picture. Here we had an exhibition with information about International Women's Day. Some information, pictures, comments in our pavilion of culture, cultural pavilion. You can visit us in Second Life. I am broadcasting. I am talking from that place. My avatar is over there now. The Day of the Dead is a very important celebration in Mexico, so we talk about that. The idea is to promote, to create, to help our students in their language, in their study language, in the language studies, with cultural activities. Okay, here we were talking about the Benito Juarez, a very important historic important person, celebrity in our history. Is that possible to use celebrity? Okay, well, it's a celebrity, historic celebrity. Here we have an exhibition of Mexican Revolution, and here is another picture of the Carnival of Mazatlán. We were celebrate, and if you can see, we wear special costumes from the carnival, so we learned the language having fun. Yeah, of course, we are serious in our classes, but we have fun. It's important, okay, to enjoy the classes, to have fun, to have parties, why not? Yeah, it's part of our activities to teach the language. Okay, now in the slide number 15 slide, you can see the exhibition, more example of the exhibition we organized. Here, let me show. Here we have the Day of the Dead in this picture, in this, and in this. Part of our cultural activities is to ask our student to perform themselves like a Latin, okay? To live the culture of we, the Spanish speakers. And Day of the Dead is a very important activity, cultural activity. So I asked my student to decorate an altar, okay, like we do, like we Mexican do in real life. So they decorate, they discover why we decorate that altar. So that way we can understand, okay, can understand the language, living the cultural activities. Here we have an exhibition of Benito Juarez. You can see the picture. Other picture of Women's Day, International Women's Day. This is our last, one of our last activities in Spanish speak. Here we were talking about the Day of the Dead, and especially an artist from Mexico, Guadalupe Posada. We were talking about that. That girl here is one of our students, wearing a Katrina costume. So we have that possibility, okay, to perform the roles, the characters in our cultural activities, in our culture, in our history. And here we have an exhibition of the revolution also. We have not only the pictures, we have information, note cards with information in Spanish and English also, because we get visitors from all the world. So, well, if not don't know, if they don't know Spanish, well, they can read the note cards in English. So we help, okay, we help the opportunity. We help all the person to learn more about us, about, well, especially we because Mexico, because we are Mexican. But not only, the idea is not only to show Mexico, of course, is if they are more Spanish teacher, well, not only Mexico, other teachers. Now let's continue with the slide number 16. Let me open. Slide 16, please wait for me. We continue here. We are going to talk about the what. Okay, a little slow. Please, come on. Oh, well, okay. Have problems with my internet connection. No, yeah, it is. Cultural lectures. Other of our activities, well, me, my special activity is to offer lectures. Yeah, I love to talk. Can you discover that? Yes. I love to talk about my culture, my history, Mexican history. So always I am of talking about revolution, independence, Day of the Dead, the Guelaguetza party in the state of Oaxaca, the Christmas time, the way we celebrate Christmas, but not only the historical or artistic event. I have a commitment to work for the women's right, to avoid violence against women. So I talk about the rights, the women's rights, the ends of the violence, a lot of topics about women. So we participate here. We have let me use the arrow. Here we were talking about gender violence, and here about I can't see very well the title of the slide, but we were talking about women's rights. So always I am insisting in that, and I hope someday we can finish. Okay, we can avoid that violence against women. Okay, let's go to the 16th slide and let's talk about some parties. Yeah, one of our activities, my activities, and not only mine, of course, is a work of the team, is to organize concerts, karaoke activities, DJ music. Of course, the music we offer in these activities most of the time is in Spanish. I said most of the time because we have changed a little. At the karaoke, for example, here we were having a contest. Not only our students, we invite our students to participate, but our Spanish speaker friends. We can sing song in Spanish, so that the student have the possibility to listen us pronouncing our Spanish. We have conversation in our parties in order to help our student to see the way we talk, the way we write. Of course, me, like a teacher, I have to write a correct Spanish. If I have a mistake, oh, that is a problem for me. Well, other of our friends have some mistake, it is natural, but if we have a mistake here in our chat conversation, well, I correct. In order you have the opportunity to see the way we speak in an informal way and the correct Spanish, okay? So always we are not only having a party just to have a party, no, just to celebrate, no. All our activities are focused on that, to help our students in the practice of the language. Mm-hmm. And this is me. Can you see? This is me. This is the Llorona, the crier. We have a special character in the Day of the Dead activity, the Llorona, the crier. So I can perform, okay? I can change myself into the characters. We talk about that. Okay, so that is good. I use again the avatars to teach Spanish. Okay, here is our friend Wilson Ross. He is the dead man, maybe a zombie. I don't know. He's dead. So well, we can do that. We can play that. Be alive. Be dead. That's funny in Second Life, okay? Here we are celebrating. Mariachi dead, exactly, it's a mariachi dead. Very funny, very funny. And here, again, celebrating the Halloween, not only because we want to change our activities, no, it's just to compare, the difference of our culture. So that way we can understand, even for me, I can understand better the culture of my student, the way they think, and I can use that information to help my class, okay? It's a mutual learning. vocabulary at the class. Like I said, the main phrases, main words I use in the class. Question and answer, and the orders I am going to give. At the class number 6, we study the feminine and masculine words, singular and plural words. Feminine and masculine is important because our nouns in Spanish are or feminine or masculine, and according of that we have to match our article. We use articles, very important in Spanish. The pronunciation is okay, Laus or Laus. Maggie, ¿estás aquí? Ah, excelente. Dime cuando ya pueda empezar. Sí, excelente. Yupi. Dame un green light. Is that possible to say that in English? Okay, muy bien. Continúo. Perfecto. Entonces, estábamos hablando de los conciertos. The classes in English. We were talking about concert, DJs, and karaoke. Yeah, we do all that activities to support our classes, okay? We celebrate, yeah, we sing, we have chats, conversation in chat, sometimes in voice, all of that conversation or singing in Spanish, okay, to help our student to practice the language. Now, let's continue with the slide number 18. Yeah, it's 18. Radio Spanish Speak. We can use radio in Second Life. It's another, well, tool. We could use, of course, radio out of Second Life, but we use radio inside Second Life, part of our tools. For example, me, I offer my lectures on radio, or my classes on radio. I have no possibility to show here the photographs. How can I show? Well, here we have some pictures about my classes. To the left, the picture of the left. Those are my classes on radio, Spanish Explorer, topics in intermediate and advanced Spanish, and straight Spanish class. That classes are on radio. We have a special schedule for classes, so our student can have these classes, can use these classes to support the regular classes, the normal classes at the classroom. They can listen the live classes or the recorded classes in Radio Spanish Speak. So we offer that opportunities to continue the practice of the language, to remake a review in these topics and in intermediate and advanced Spanish. We make a review of our Spanish. So we help. Okay, we have a lot of opportunity to do that. And we offer the poet time on Radio Spanish Speak, also La Hora del Poeta, to talk about literature. Okay, one of our activities, one of our events is to talk about literature. So we could discover more writers in Spanish, famous writers of why not, and famous, all of literature in Spanish on Radio Spanish Speak. So that is another tool to learn. The theater workshop. Yeah, we have a special activity, the theater workshop. In theater workshop, we play some characters in a specific place. Our students have the possibility to, well, we don't, it is not necessary to be a good actor, no, to get an Oscar of our performance, of course not. Well, the idea is to practice the language, to feel the feelings in our play, okay? To play a specific character, be a mother, be a father, be a son, be a friend, be a teacher, be a office worker, different scenarios to help our practice. Here we have some pictures of the place we were performed in the past, and our students are in that place. One of our special students, he is here with us. Maggie Larimore is my, how can I say, my musa in the place. He always participate in the place, so she is my musa. Okay, so you see some pictures with her in our place. Okay, now let's talk about collaborative actions. Well, maybe it's not a good title. Maybe the title could be "The Way I Use Other Scenes." I have to touch the blackboard. Okay, please let me back. Please let me back on the blackboard. Okay. Okay. Can I? Please, I have to touch the blackboard. Let me touch the blackboard, okay? I have to, because I'm following my list of topics, okay? Please let me back on the blackboard. We almost finishing, so let me talk a little more about that. Okay. I was talking about collaborative action of, yeah, please, yeah, that will be okay. Thank you, Maggie. Okay, so the way I use other themes, yeah, exactly, not good. Next year, maybe. collaborative action or the way I use other themes. Yes, I take some advantages of other themes. The other Latin themes, like Mexico Auténtico, Mi Casa es Tu Casa, SL Argentina, Colombia Amor, Virtual Spain, Mexico Mi México, Opera Joven, Second USMP, Costa Rica, Universo Creativo, Unhispana, all of that themes help me. In my classes, they have different scenarios. They have cultural activities for example, from Spain, very very important. From Costa Rica, they have exhibition about that country. In Opera Joven, they talk about Mexico also. Universo Creativo is a theme. They teach Spanish classes, but not specifically in Spanish. classes in Spanish, okay, building classes, and that kind of activities helps also our classes. We visit those places, we can read the information, we can see the buildings they create. Not only we the Spanish speak, we do that activities for our students. Other teams help me a lot to teach my classes, to talk about other countries, for example, Spain, very important. So I use that place, okay? They helped me a lot. At the beginning of my classes, I was scared because some of the themes change. Yeah, they change or maybe disappear or maybe, well, they suffer changes. So I was scared. Oh my God, I lost that places. Well, now, not worry about that. The Latin people, Mexican, Costa Rica, Argentina, all of they are creating constantly the themes, changing the themes, creating another new themes. So I only change my activities. I only change my program. If I can't visit Colombia more, for example, well, I can go to Spain or to Colombia, Costa Rica. Well, some of them are only for party, but doesn't matter. They help. They help a lot for my classes. So I collaborate with them. Well, they collaborate with me. And now, well, especially commentary about Mi Casa es su casa. My house is your house. The translation. We have, special place to practice Spanish. The teacher, I insist, and I want to say thank you, teacher Calisto Encinal, because they let me and they let us, Spanish teacher, to use this place, a special place to practice Spanish. So I use a lot. Okay. And more cultural places, Machu Picchu, for example, the virtual USMP, the University of San Martín de Porres in Peru. They have this wonderful place, Machu Picchu. Here they have information about this archaeological place and about history, about cultural Peruvian culture. They organize activities in Spanish, so I can, if they offer a lecture or they offer a special exhibition, well, I can go with my student. If I have the opportunity, of course, because we have different schedule, different times to work, we use the activities they organize over there. Okay, because they speak Spanish, mm-hmm. And they speak a different accent of Spanish, so we can compare, okay, not only my Spanish, the Spanish of other Latin Spanish speaker countries. So we use, I use that places. And a little more, well, to make a summary, to think about that, let me to say something, to conclude, to finish this lecture. We say Second Life is a tool, a wonderful tool to teach. Yes, it is. But we have some problems. We have some advantages and some disadvantages. Why? Well, first, technical issues. For us, well, especially for me, for us, the Spanish teacher, if we want to offer a perfect class, the greatest class is possible to offer, we have to have a great computer, okay? Our computer has to be powerful. We have to buy great or how can I say, power hardware. If we have that, a very good computer, my class is not going to be okay. Okay. Even for my student need to have, if they want, not only my class, other kind of classes, if they want to work better in a class, well, we have to made more powerful our computers. So, and it means we have to invest. Well, I have to invest in my computer, and we have to do that. Okay, so that technical issues could stop or could may suffer my class. Okay, so we need to. I need to. We as teacher, we need to consider that the technical issues. Our internet connection. Yes, have to same. We have to have a faster the faster connection we is possible to have, because the fastest connection we is possible or more fast to, well, we need to improve our connection, because if we don't have a good internet connection, we can't offer a very good class. Second Life as a game. Well, yeah, is Second Life is a game. Playing. Okay, we could use Second Life playing and learning, or learning with a play, okay, with Second Life. So, well, somebody maybe don't think to teach or to take a class in Second Life. Well, they think like that. It's okay. But other people discover the way to learn a language in Second Life. So, it is possible. Yeah, we can continue teaching in Second Life with virtual worlds, because more people know that. Okay, so they know that and they take the classes. Low cost of classes. Oh, well, for me, it is good for our student, because our classes are not expensive. We can offer cheaper classes. For us, you know, the teachers, well, not bad. It's not bad. We can get more customer, more clients if the classes are cheap. And if we have the most students we can have, the more students we can have, well, is the more possibility to get more money. Yeah. So, not bad. It's not bad. It is good. It's good for us. Please wait for. I'm sorry. Here I am. Differences in time zones. Well, maybe it is a little problem, because we have, I have a specialist to teach, and maybe I lose opportunities in another country, Australia, for example. The time is very different, so we have too many hours. In a different schedules, so it is a disadvantage. But well, we Spanish teacher or Spanish teacher of languages, we can't consider that and make some changes of our schedule. Maybe not be so strict. We have to be flexible to get more students. Okay, so, yeah, we need to talk in that. Okay, and well, to conclude this class, of course, we have technical issues, we have problems with internet, the idea of Second Life like a game, the difference of time zones, but we are changing, okay? We teacher, we have to change to change our schedule a little. Okay, to get the more students we can get, okay, to offer opportunities to our students in the world. That is very good. Oh, well, that is another good reason to Second Life. We can have students from all the world. Mm-hmm. And we have to make some changes in our lifestyle. So, yeah, we could change. And technical issue, for example, the advances in technological resources, for example. Yeah, exactly. Well, not. I don't know, like my other friends. I am not a vampire like my friends here. They know who they are, who are they. Yeah, we need to change our schedule. Yes. Well, I have to do that. And well, talking about technological issues, the technological advances are fast. So, with the time, we can get more hardware, for example, for our computer, the velocity of the internet can be faster in the future. They are advancing fast, so we can fix that kind of problems in the future because of the technological advances and because of the advances in the velocity of internet. So may in the future we have, I think, and I have, I hope, we are going to work better with Spanish teachers of languages, or any teacher. We can work better in the future because of that changes. Okay, so why not use Second Life? Yes, we have. It is good. It is possible to use Second Life to teach Spanish. And with that, I finish my lecture. Thank you. Thank you, all of you. Thank you, Maggie, for this opportunity. Thank you, SL MOOC. Thank you, Maggie. Thank you, our team, Malu, which helped me here in Second Life. Thank you, Wilson. And thank you, all the other people in WizIQ. We couldn't say hello. We couldn't say goodbye. But next time I can do. Okay, thank you, Maggie. Thank you. We finished. I am finishing my presentation. And I need an applause for me. Oh, great. Excellent. Excellent. Yeah, I am. Gracias, Maggie. Gracias.